Hi folks, this is Ole Fruit. I'm standing in front of Hotel Tigaiga on the island of Tenerife in the city of Puerto. And not only does Puerto have the best botanic garden in all of the Canary Islands, and not only does Tenerife have a climate where you can grow basically everything, but the hotels in Puerto, they try to outdo each other with having the best subtropical / tropical ornamental and sometimes even fruit garden. But of all those hotels, none is as famous as the Hotel Tigaiga. Its garden is basically in almost every tourist guide of Tenerife, and even when I went into the garden, it says property of the government of the Canary Islands. And even here again, it says Puerto de la Cruz. So this seems to be part of the city property, while other parts of the garden seem to be part of the island, of the island's government property. Well, let's see what kind of nice trees we have here. This could be some Roystonia, also those tall palms in the background. Here we have the European dwarf palm, Chamaerops humilis. It has edible fruit, but not very tasty, but still better than the fruit of Roystonia. Well, here we have Cycas. It might look like a palm, but it's more closely related to conifers and highly toxic. You shouldn't try to eat any part of the plant. Not even I will dare to do this. Another Cycas, Schefflera or Basaya. Here a Monstera and an Epipremnum. I think it's called Epipremnum. Two plants which look very different, but Epipremnum will have smaller non-edible fruit, while Monstera has this big cob of corn-like inflorescences of fruit which you can eat if you know how. But they are only for those who know how to eat them, because those Monstera fruit are really dangerous if you don't know how to use them. What do we have here? Some Erythrina tree. This could be a Fehoa. No fruit. I think that's too much shade for it, this Fehoa tree. Some fishtail palm, Cariota. Some of the fruit actually almost edible, but most of the Cariota fruit will just give you horrible stings in your throat. This is some citrus, maybe a bitter orange or something like that. Oh, here we have oleander, horribly toxic. Even making your barbecue fire from the wood of this shrub can kill you. Some big yucca, some brugmansia. Oh, nice and tasty lily pili. An Australian fruit, look at those. Yummy. Already starting to get ripe. Beautiful. Those taste like really nice tangy apples. Here's some asparagus. This is an ornamental plant. The fruit is not edible, but the bulbs are. In commercial asparagus species, the stems are edible, but in this species, I'm pretty sure the bulbs are edible. Not much taste and nutritional value, but nice and refreshing. I'm not sure if this is a Brahea armata. No, this is something different. Oh god, I should really learn my palm trees. This one is hard to confuse with anything else. Some giant Carnegiea or saguaro cacti. They have edible fruit, but I've never seen fruit in the Canary Islands. I think they lack the pollinators. Here's some Washingtonia palms. Very tasty heart of palm, and also tasty edible fruit. Never seen anyone using them here. This tall tree actually has fruit. Never seen anyone using them here. But in Arizona, people would collect them to eat them out of hand and even to make wine or other liquors out of them. Yeah, this is all Washingtonia, tall Washingtonia, short Washingtonia. A small puny Plumeria alba tree. This is some Dracaena. This could be the dragon tree of Madagascar. This is some ginger relative. Maybe this is Alpinia. Nice. Flowers, you can eat the flowers, leaves, stems, and try some Sinmo's ginger, species and relatives of ginger. Here we have Strelitzia regina, one of the most popular souvenirs from the Canary Islands. A small palm fern. Here we come to the part which is government property. Like over there in front it was city property, here it's island property. Really strange. Which is there even a part which is private property of the hotel? I don't know, but basically since it's in every tourist guide, I guess it's possible to visit it. Here we have dragon trees. Funny thing about dragon trees, Canarian dragon trees, Trachera dracoes, they can grow to quite a size before developing the first branch. This is over 4 meters tall and 30 centimeters, so about a foot thick. No branches. This one is about the same height and it's starting to branch, very short branches. Here a stockier one, which already has branched into 4. Well, this one broke off and had to develop 2 branches. And here we have one, about 3.5 meters tall. Not a single branch, but already a bunch of fruit. I hope you can see anything when I'm filming against the sky. Here, the endemic Canary date palm, Phoenix canariensis, a staple ornamental plant in all Mediterranean and subtropical areas of the world. And here, the Phoenix tactilifera from Africa and Arabia, a rare specimen which is branching. Actually, here in Puerto, I see a lot of those branching Phoenix tactilifera, maybe some genotype which is quite common here. As you can see, the Phoenix tactilifera, the habitus is a bit different. The fronds are longer and more slender and also more grayish bluish, while the ones of Phoenix canariensis are more greenish yellowish. Also the stem is usually, the trunk is usually thicker. Agave attenuata, the spineless agave. If you have children or people who tend to trip in the garden, don't plant spiny agaves, plant this agave attenuata. A small Scheffler actinophylla. I hope we'll get some better specimens. A really beautiful tree. Some more dragon trees here. Here we have some aloe. I don't know which one this is. Is this an aloe? No, it's not an aloe ferox. Is it a big aloe vera? I'm really not good at aloe. Those things here which look like cacti are actually spurges. This could be the local Euphorbia canariensis. You don't see the spines, but they are there and they are really, really nasty and sharp. But they are not the most dangerous thing about the spurges. Here we have one from Africa. And those two species, they are really dangerous. Not because of the quite short spines. Well, the spines are also dangerous, but when injured, they will produce a white milky sap, which can actually blind you. So stay away from spurges. They are more dangerous than cacti. Down here I saw some really nice and some really bright red mushrooms. Not really a fruit, but quite nice. On the video, they are not as bright as in real life. They are basically like painted. Oh, here we have another of the native spurges. This one looks like a small, slightly succulent tree. So the spurges around here can look very different. We also have the typical herb-like spurges. Here we have some Opuntia species, which is quite common in this area. I don't know exactly which one it is. Tons of fruits, they turn kind of yellowish when ripe. Also here you can see that the fruit are actually stems because they are branching. There are other fruit growing out of the fruit, and this is no exception at all. Look, it's actually quite common. In some Opuntia species you actually can have chains of 5 or 6 fruit growing from one another. Here the flower. So I don't know exactly which cactus species this is. It's some Opuntia species. I know exactly what this is. This is the famous Opuntia ficus indica with huge and tasty fruit. Look at the size of this fruit. And in the 19th and 20th century, this plant single-handedly carried the whole economy of the Canary Islands. Not the fruit. The fruit were eaten. The stems were also eaten mostly by animals. In Mexico, they eat the stems or those flat things people think are the leaves as vegetable. Here in Spain, they usually just feed them to the animals. But what was the important and valuable part about those cacti? Were actually the bugs living on them. See those bugs with the red blood? This blood was a very important dye. You would dye basically everything with it, mostly fabric. And then the Germans invented artificial aniline colors, and the whole economy of the Canary Islands crashed, having like half of the population immigrate to America. Nowadays, the dye is still being produced, mostly off the island of Lanzarote, but it's a small-scale economy. Basically, in Morocco or in other poor countries, you can produce it much cheaper since it's basically only labor-intensive. You have to scrape off those bugs from the cacti, and in countries with cheap labor, it's much easier to produce. But it's still a significant economy worldwide. You paint things like Campari and Martini and a lot of candy with this dye from bugs. Yeah, this government, this insular government part of the park is not very biodiverse. It's really beautiful, but there are hundreds of specimens of the same plants. And those sites, I guess if you have some brochure or app or website, you can check all the names of the different plants. Maybe I should have done this beforehand. By the way, this Hotel Tigaiga Park is standing amidst a lot of other nice parks and botanical gardens here on this hill in Puerto de la Cruz. On the other side of the street, there is the big park de la Sortilla. Very nice for jogging or gymnastics or stuff. Here we have the old Hotel Tauro. To the right of the building, there is the private part of the park of the Hotel Tauro. And behind the building, there is the steep slope of the Tauro Park. Another very interesting but slightly neglected park. And then behind it, there are my favorite botanic gardens of all of Puerto and Tenerife. The Risco Belo and Jardín Acuático, which are closed right now. I really hope they will open them at least in December. And behind them there is the Sitio Litre or Orchid Garden. And here this slope, I don't know which park it officially belongs to, but there are also some quite interesting parts with interesting fruit trees. Here we have another Opuntia species which I should identify. To the right of it, a pink peppercorn tree, Cirrus molle. This ficus here could be Ficus lyrata, or could be something completely different. Here's some agave, probably Zizalada. And on the inflorescences, there are actually no flowers and fruit, but it produces hundreds and hundreds of young plants. And wherever those plants fall, they don't consist just of a single seed, but of a finished plant with leaves and a bud in the middle and even small rudimentary roots. So after the next rain, they can immediately start growing. And no wonder agave are invasive. Those little plants, they are very good for short-range dispersal, while the seeds on the fruit which don't exist in those plants are very good for more long-range dispersal. Let's see what we get here. Yeah, here is the Cirrus molle, the Peruvian peppercorn tree. Here, Euphorbia tirocali, a huge tree like euphorb. Here again, some of the local euphorbs. I even forgot their names. As I said, the insular government part of the park is not very biodiverse. Now we are going to the other side of the hotel, where they have a lot more diversity. I still don't understand the property distribution here. Like, part of the park belongs to the city, part belongs to the island. Oh yeah, here again. City. No. Amigos del Puerto. This must be some NGO which is taking care of this part. It's really interesting. It doesn't even seem to be private. It seems to be a public park surrounding a hotel. Maybe that's the reason why it's in every tourist guide of the island. Here, is this a Washingtonia? No, this must be some really massive sabal palm. The stem is less than half a meter tall, but look at those leaves. The leaves are more than 1.5 meters in diameter. This is some barrel cactus, but they are rarely edible fruit here. Don't even know what those are. Oh, here is the mother-in-law cactus. Basically, when your mother-in-law comes visiting you, you put a small blanket on top of this cactus and let her sit on top of it. That's why it's called mother-in-law cactus. Here a huge aloe. And here again the Carnegiea gigantea or zaguaro from Mexico and Arizona, with old flowers and new flower buds, but no fruit, unfortunately. Okay, let's see what we have here. Ah yeah, there is a lot of Scheffler obasaya actinophylla. Some nice rainforest cactus, of which I forgot the name, growing as a vine with adhesive roots growing up this canary date palm. Look at that. Amazing. Some hibiscus, most probably Hibiscus rosazinensis. Here we have the Brazilian peppercorn tree, but no peppercorns on this one. Here a hibiscus flower, unfortunately in the shade. Some strelitzia flowers, also unfortunately in the shade. As I said, this is a very popular souvenir from the Canary Islands. Oh look, here there is some fruit of the strelitzia regina. You don't see those very often. Nice pollinated fruit with well-developed seeds. Basically what you do... Oh, here, look, here there is a ripe fruit, which is spreading its seeds. This plant is very common on the Canary Islands. The fact that it produces good fruit here means that it must feel very well. Usually the souvenir you take with you is a flower bud like this, which can survive the transport very well. Once you go home to your home country, you put it in water and then develops into such beautiful orange and violet flowers, but it's a very rare thing for it to develop nice fruit. Let's see what we have here. This must be some sort of sabal. This is some sort of phoenix with Boston fern growing on it. Brugmansia with nice and dangerous flowers. This is some Araceae, I even forgot the name. I forgot half the names. This is another Strelitzia. Strelitzia Nicolae or Alba. Those seem to be quite puny Scheffler actinophylla. And I don't even see a single inflorescence. Pity. Here, by the way, Ficus benjamini, like we know it in more temperate areas, it's growing in a flower pot. But here you can basically plant it outside and you get a full-size tree, 15, 20, 25 meters tall. And here look at this asparagus with the edible little bulbs. They don't have a lot of nutrients, but they are nice and refreshing. You cannot eat the fruit, but you can eat the bulbs. Here this other Scheffler Basai, I forgot the name, sorry for that. See, here we have still a small but considerably bigger tree of Ficus Benjamini growing outside, and it can even grow to much, much bigger sizes. Here is a small succulent garden with a lot of agave and cactus species. Here, as you can see, you can grow bougainvillea not only as a vine but also as a bonsai-like plant. There are varieties which are stunt, which have short stems. You still have to prune them regularly, but there are lots of areas. For example, in Indonesia or in Malaysia, most of the bougainvillea I saw was in flower pots. I don't know if it's a fashion or if in moister climates you have to keep them in flower pots, but this is an alternative. You don't need to have it develop into a 10-meter vine. You can actually keep it in a flower pot and keep it really small, less than a meter in size. This is a beautiful part of this garden. Look at that, so many different palms. Maybe I should have gotten the brochure or downloaded the app or whatever you use with those numerous signs everywhere. This is a tiny papaya tree. Nice, this will produce nice fruit. At least I hope so. More palms. This should be Roystonia. I even forget the name of this one. Some nicely colored chamaerops. Here the tree is a nice big Schefflera. Background a nice big Monstera. Oh god, I really forgot half of the names of those plants. Incredible. Well folks, this was the famous park of the Hotel Tigaiga. Well, let's look at this Caryota palm then and finish the video. Look at this. Well, here is Spatodea campanulata, an African tulip tree. Behind it, a nice greenish yellowish Caryota with beautiful big leaves. So this was the beautiful park of Hotel Tigaiga on the island of Tenerife. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the island of Tenerife. And don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe.